In this video, we're going to start the Work Word Problems worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. This is a free worksheet that you can find within the Algebra 2 section. And the subsection that this worksheet falls under is the equations and inequalities. Number 1 says Stefan left school and traveled toward his friend's house. Eugene left 2 hours later, traveling at 40 kilometers per hour in an effort to catch up with Stefan. So we know that Eugene left 2 hours later, and he traveled at 40 kilometers per hour. After traveling for 3 hours, Eugene finally caught up. So Eugene traveled a total of 3 hours. What we're trying to figure out is what was Stefan's average speed. So we know that Eugene left 2 hours after Stefan did, and he traveled 40 kilometers per hour. But he traveled that 40 kilometers per hour for 3 hours until he caught up. So Eugene traveled 40 kilometers per hour, and he traveled that for 3 hours. So if we multiplied 40 kilometers per hour by 3 hours, we'll get the total distance that Eugene had traveled. And that will equal the total distance that Stefan traveled. However, Stefan left 2 hours before Eugene, since Eugene left 2 hours later. So as opposed to traveling a total of 3 hours, Stefan traveled a total of 2 plus 3 hours, which was 5 hours. So Stefan traveled a total of 5 hours. However, we're trying to figure out what his average speed was. So let's call this variable x. So 40 kilometers per hour times 3 hours, the total distance Eugene traveled, is going to equal the average speed of Stefan times 5 hours, which will be the total distance that Stefan had traveled, and their total distance should be the same. We're solving for the average speed of Stefan, which we called variable x. So 40 kilometers per hour times 3 hours is going to equal 120 kilometers because the hours essentially will cancel out. So 40 kilometers per hour times 3 hours will equal 120 kilometers. And that's equal to x times 5 hours. Now, what we need to do is to divide both sides by 5 hours. So x, Stefan's average speed, is equal to 120 kilometers divided by 5 hours. So that's going to be 24 kilometers per hour. So Stefan traveled 120 kilometers in 5 hours. So his average speed was 24 kilometers per hour. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, it says Ginny traveled to the lake and back. On the trip there, she traveled 80 kilometers per hour. So she traveled 80 kilometers per hour on the speed there, and on her return trip, on her way back, she went 60 kilometers per hour. So that was her speed on the way back. It's asking us how long did it take the trip there? So how many hours did it take for her to get to the lake if the return trip took a total of 4 hours. So she traveled there at 80 kilometers per hour, and we're looking for how long it took her to get there. So that is going to be a variable. Let's make the variable this time y. That's going to be equal to her return trip speed of 60 kilometers per hour times how long it took her return trip, which is 4 hours. So now we're going to work out the math. 80 kilometers per hour times y is going to be 80 kilometers per hour times y, and that's going to be equal to 60 kilometers per hour times 4 hours, which is 240 kilometers. So the total distance of the trip is 240 kilometers. And if she went 80 kilometers per hour on her way there, we're going to divide 80 kilometers per hour from both sides. We're going to take 240, divide that by 80, and we're going to get a total of 3 hours. So y is equal to 3 hours, and y was how long the trip there took. And that we got was 3 hours. And that's because to get there or to get back is 240 kilometers. And since she was traveling at 80 kilometers per hour, 240 divided by 80 gives us 3 hours. And number 3, Shayna left the airport and drove toward the capital at an average speed of 52 kilometers per hour. So Shayna's speed is 52 kilometers per hour. Sometime later, May left driving in the same direction, but at an average speed of 65 kilometers per hour. After driving for 4 hours, May caught up with Shayna. So May traveled a total of 4 hours at 65 kilometers per hour. And what we're going to do is find the number of hours that Shayna drove, knowing that her speed was 52 kilometers per hour, before May had actually caught up to her. So Shayna drove at 52 kilometers per hour, and we do not know how long she drove for. So that's going to be our variable. Let's call this variable A. However, we know that May caught up to Shayna driving at 65 kilometers per hour, and she caught up only after 4 hours. So we're multiplying 65 kilometers per hour by 4 hours. When we multiply 65 by 4, we get that May drove a total distance of 260 kilometers. And since they were driving the same direction, Shayna also had drove 260 kilometers. So Shayna, driving 52 kilometers per hour, traveled for an unknown amount of hours, A, and that's going to be equal to 260 kilometers total. So our next step is to divide both sides by 52 kilometers per hour. Since that is Shayna's speed, and we know the total distance traveled. So A, the number of hours that Shayna traveled, is equal to 260 kilometers divided by 52 kilometers per hour, which is equal to 5 hours. You can think of kilometers canceling out, so we're left with just hours. So Shayna drove a total of 5 hours before May caught up to her. And finally, let's go over number 4. And after we go over the answer to this, I'll stop the video here before picking up with the next problem on this worksheet in the next video. And before I do this, go ahead, like my video, and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Each like and subscription lets me know that you're finding these videos helpful, which encourages me to make more videos for you. So, in number 4, Lisa traveled to her cabin on the lake and back. The trip there took a total of 5 hours, and the trip back took a total of 6 hours. She traveled an average speed of 45 kilometers per hour on her return trip, so that was her trip back. We need to find the average speed of her trip there. So let's make the average speed of her trip there a variable x. So x times the amount of time it took her to get there, which was 5 hours, is going to equal her speed on the way back, which was 45 kilometers per hour, times the total time it took to get back, which was 6 hours. So we have x times 5 hours equal to 45 kilometers per hour times 6 hours, which is equal to 270 kilometers. So we know now that the total distance that she traveled to get there is the same distance as it is to get back, which is 270 kilometers. And since it took her 5 hours to get there, traveling 270 kilometers, we're going to divide both sides by 5 hours. So x, her average speed, will equal 270 kilometers divided by 5 hours, which is 54 kilometers per hour. Since 270 divided by 5 is 54. So 54 kilometers per hour is the final solution in this video. Continue on to the next video, where I'll do numbers 5 through 8.